Hello students, welcome to RH Chemistry. In today's final punch, KCET previous year questions, general principles and process of isolation of elements I am going to discuss. Question papers from 2014 to 2018 I have discussed, although 2013 also I have included in this particular case. So then 2019 paper already I have solved, so that the link I have given in the description that you can see. Before going to start with this chapter, previous year questions, let us discuss some important synopsis part in this particular case. So quick synopsis we will discuss, then we will move to the question. General principles and process of isolation of elements I have written in shortcut. So in this particular case, remember, first step, concentration of the ore. In the extraction of the metal, remember, the first step is concentration of the ore. So, before going to start with concentration of the ore, let me tell you some important the ores which we have to remember. That is, first one, aluminium. If you see, aluminium, two important ores you have to remember. That is, first one is bauxite, Al2O3XS2O. Second one is cryolite, Na3AlF6. And the iron you have to remember. These are the important ore. Hematite Fe2O3, magnetite Fe3O4, siderite FeCO3, iron pyrite FeS2, limonite 2Fe2O3 3S2O, wolframite FeWO4. These are the ores for iron you have to remember. Then remember for copper, copper pyrite CuFeS2. This is the one ore having both copper and iron, remember. Cuprite Cu2O. Last year it was asked, oxidation state of copper is +1 here. Copper glands Cu2S, malachite CuCO3, CuOH twice, and azurite, 2 moles of the same malachite, 2 CuCO3, CuOH twice. This is of copper. Then zinc you have to remember. So zinc blend, ZnS, zinc blend, zincite, ZnO, then calamine, ZnCO3. Then remaining some other metals ores I have taken. That is, remember this PbS, galena, CaCO3, MgCO3 called as dolomite, Ag2S is argentite, HgS is cinnabar, SnO2 is cassiterite, then FeCr2O4 is chromite, and MnO2 we know that pyrolusite. So these are the ore you have to remember for the CET or NEET or JE exam point of view. If you remember these many ores, it is enough. Then let us continue with these, the synopsis part. So in case of the metallurgy, we will call it as this particular chapter. In case of this metallurgy, remember, so step one is concentration of the ore. So in that concentration of the ore, first one is, remember this, first one is gravity separation method or hydraulic washing method, or it is also called as levigation. So in all these four methods I will discuss, in all the case, remember the examples, very very important. Any oxide ores you can use. So gravity separation method, hydraulic washing or levigation, oxide ores are used. So remember that. And the second one very important is magnetic separation method. So magnetic separation method. So second one, magnetic separation method. The example, SnO2 containing FeWO4 as magnetic impurity. So tin oxide, cassiterite containing wolframite as magnetic impurity, you can go for this. And the third one is, remember, very very important. So froth flotation method. Froth flotation method, in this the method, the sulfide ore is used. Very very important, remember my dear students. So sulfide ores are used in froth flotation method, and in which collectors are used, that is, example is pine oil, eucalyptus oil, etc., which to increase the non-wettability of ore with the water. Very important, increase the non-wettability of ore with the water. And froth stabilizers are used, that is aniline or chrysols, to stabilize the ore, that stabilize the froth. And depressants are used to separate two sulfide ores. For example, if ZnS and PbS is present, we are going to use NaCN as a depressant, which can allow PbS to mix with the froth. PbS to mix with the froth, and ZnS reacts with NaCN to form soluble complex. So this is froth flotation method, remember that. Then we'll move to leaching. So leaching is the method Leaching is the method where first example I have taken bauxite. So impurity present in bauxite, first very important, last year it was asked Fe2O3 TiO2 and SiO2. Remember, impurities are Fe2O3 TiO2 and SiO2, and in the first step NaOH, this it should not be NaOH, so this should be Al2O3 XH2O. When it reacts with NaOH, Al2O3 XH2, when it reacts with sodium hydroxide to form a complex sodium aluminate, which on reaction with CO2 to form hydrated alumina, on heating gives alumina. So very important this complex. About this also once the question was asked, very important, remember that point. So sodium aluminate. So these are nothing but the important four methods for the concentration of the ore. Then the second step we will see. Second step in this particular case is, remember, step 2, conversion into oxide. So step 2, two sub methods. First one is conversion into oxide, second one is reduction of oxide to crude metal. So reduction of oxide to the crude metal. So remember that particular point. So now what we'll do, conversion into oxides we'll see. To conversion into oxide, remember, we are going to use the method, first one, calcination. First one is calcination, and the second one is, remember, roasting. Calcination and the second one is roasting. So what is calcination? See, in this particular case, heating ore in absence of oxygen. Calcination, which means you have to remember absence of oxygen, and which is used for carbonates and hydrated oxide ores. It is used for carbonates and hydrated oxide ores, and thermal decomposition take place. Remember, thermal decomposition take place. Second one, roasting. Roasting is the method of heating a ore in presence of oxygen. Remember, presence of oxygen, and here it is only used for sulfide ore. For sulfide ores, remember, we have two methods. One is froth flotation method only for sulfide ore, and the second one is roasting only for sulfide ores. So that is, in this case, remember, oxidation is a process to take place, and both these can be carried out in reverberatory furnace. Which furnace? Reverberatory furnace. Remember that. So this is about the first step, conversion into oxide. After we get converted into the oxide, then we will do reduction of the oxide to crude metal. Remember, reduction of oxide to crude metal. In this reduction of oxide to crude metal, we will take use of which diagram? Remember, Ellingham diagram. Very important, Ellingham diagram. Then what is Ellingham diagram? It is the simple graph of delta G naught versus temperature for the formation of oxides. Remember, formation of the oxides. So in this case, one principle what you have to remember is, very important, element with more negative delta G naught can reduce metal oxide with less negative delta G naught. Remember, element with more negative delta G naught can reduce metal oxide with less negative delta G naught. So very important, remember. For example, if it is less than 983, this 1073 Kelvin will take, less than 1073 Kelvin. So in the Ellingham diagram, remember, less than 1073 Kelvin, carbon monoxide is present below iron. Hence, carbon monoxide act as reducing agent for Fe2O3. So remember, less than 1073 Kelvin, carbon monoxide act as reducing agent for the Fe2O3, and more than 1073 Kelvin, carbon act as reducing agent for the Fe2O3. That is because of Ellingham diagram. Then what we have to remember for Ellingham diagram? So remember, very simple, I will tell you. So this you have to remember for Ellingham diagram. The order of delta G naught values I have given, more negative to less negative. More negative to less negative. Remember, magnesium is having more and more negative. Then aluminium, zinc, iron, copper, mercury and silver. Only important metals I have considered. So very important, remember, you have to analyze this like this. Remember, magnesium can reduce Al2O3 to Al. Remember, this is metal oxide which is present above magnesium. So below in the series, having more negative can reduce metal oxide. right? So magnesium can reduce Al2O3 to Al. Similarly, aluminium can reduce ZnO to Zn. Like that you have to read. But one thing you remember, zinc cannot reduce aluminium oxide to aluminium. Aluminium cannot reduce magnesium oxide to magnesium. So this conversion not possible. Aluminium never reduce MgO, but Mg can reduce Al2O3. Al can reduce ZnO. Zinc can reduce Fe2O3. Fe can reduce Cu2O. Like that. So remember these many metals in this particular case. That is enough for Ellingham diagram. Very very important Ellingham diagram concept in this particular case. Now let us move to the extraction, second step. So what is the second step in this case? So main second step, in that the second step is, remember, so here conversion into oxide is over, reduction of oxide to crude metal. So a principle behind this we have understood. Now we will go for, remember, extraction of iron. So now we will go for extraction process, extraction of this, remember. So extraction we will discuss here. Now first one, extraction of iron, remember, extraction of iron. So what is extraction of iron? Extraction of iron is from Fe2O3, correct? So extraction of iron is from Fe2O3. So remember this, in case of the Fe2O3, so Fe2O3 mixed with carbon and CaCO3 in the ratio 8:4:1 added into the blast furnace. These are the reactions take place. So first what happens? C+O2 give rise to CO2. Then that CO2 react with C to form CO. First one is exothermic, temperature increases. Second one is endothermic, temperature decreases. Next, remember, Fe2O3 reduced by carbon monoxide, which is the reducing agent. So carbon monoxide, because temperature is less than 500 Kelvin, almost 900 to 500 Kelvin range. So carbon monoxide acts as reducing agent to Fe2O3 to form Fe plus CO2. Then CaCO3, we have taken CaCO3, that will give you CaO plus CO2. Remember, CaCO3 on heating, CaO plus CO2, CaO react with SiO2 to form CaSiO3. CaSiO3 is known as slag in this particular case, right? Then what is this CaO or CaCO3? Remember, CaO or CaCO3 is a flux. So it may be CaO or CaCO3. It is a basic flux because CaO is basic and acidic gang is present. SiO2 is the gang particle present here. So this is about the extraction of iron, remember that. Then second one, we'll discuss about extraction of zinc. In case of the extraction of zinc, remember, ZnS, first step is the froth flotation, second step is roasting. After roasting, you are going to get ZnO. Very simple, ZnO is reduced by carbon to form zinc plus carbon monoxide, but the temperature should be, according to Ellingham diagram, remember, 1673 Kelvin and above. That is extraction of zinc. So after this extraction of zinc, remember, extraction of copper. Extraction of copper, very very important self-reduction process. Self-reduction, why we call it as? Because this is a self-reduction reaction, you can see. Cu2OE is reduced by Cu2S. From where the Cu2S we have obtained? Cu2S is one of the reagent which is formed in the reaction itself, remember. So hence Cu2S, we have not added any reducing agent from externally, outside we will never added. So hence we, this is called a self-reduction process. Important, FeO is known as gang, SiO2 is known as a flux, remember. Then Cu2S is called as reducing agent, which will reduce Cu2O to form Cu. Blister copper we call it as, because of the blister appearance, remember, the sulfur dioxide gas will go out of the copper. Hence it will have a blister appearance, we will call it as blister copper. This is the extraction of copper. Then finally we will move to extraction of aluminium. Remember one thing, extraction of aluminium from electrometallurgy. Electrometallurgy antandre, so electrolysis of fused or molten salt, very very important point it is. It is, you will never take aqueous salt, remember, always you have to take fused or molten salt. Then what we'll do, Electrometallurgy is used for what all the metals? Remember that point. It will help you. Used for aluminium or alkali or alkaline earth metal extraction. Because these are all electropositive metals. Hence remember, used for aluminium or alkali or alkaline earth metals we can use. And metal is reduced at cathode. Very, very important. Metal is reduced at cathode. Now what we'll do? We'll discuss about Hall-Herald process. So what is Hall-Herald process? See, in Hall-Herald process, remember, extraction of aluminium it is. Correct? So electrolyte is used. That electrolyte is Al2O3, Na3LF6 and CaF2. Cryolite or fluorspar we call it as. Why we have added? Very, very important. To increase the conductivity of the mixture and to decrease the melting point. Remember, electrolyte, Na3LF6 or CaF2 is added to alumina because to increase the conductivity, decrease the melting point. Then which is the cathode used? Cathode used is carbon, anode used is graphite rod. Then what happens on passing electric current? Reaction take place like this. So remember, at cathode, Al3 plus reduced to alumina, aluminium. Remember, Al3 plus reduced to aluminium. At anode, carbon from where? Graphite rod itself. Remember, carbon from graphite rod itself reacts with oxygen to form CO or carbon dioxide. Because of that reason, in this process, remember, anode rods are replaced periodically. What is the reason? Periodically, it is replaced because itself undergo reaction, carbon, remember. Hence, then overall reaction is given like this. Al2O3 plus C give rise to Al plus 3CO2. It was asked in JEE exam also. Remember this one. Al2O3 plus C give rise to Al plus CO2. This is overall reaction in this particular case. This is about extraction of aluminium from alumina. Extraction of aluminium from alumina. Remember that. So after this, the four extraction, there is another two extraction which I am going to discuss. That is, first one, remember, extraction of chlorine from brine solution. Extraction of chlorine from brine solution. So extraction of chlorine from brine solution, what will happen is, so very important, NaCl will take, brine solution is sodium chloride solution. NaCl solution on electrolysis give rise to S2 and Cl2 plus NaOH. Cl2 is at anode, oxidation take place. It was asked once which process take place at anode. Oxidation take place, so Cl2 gas is evolved in this particular case. Now the second one we'll see, extraction of gold or silver. Very, very important. For gold or silver, first of all, gold or silver are native metal. Native metal antandre, so these are less reactive metals. So in this case, cyanide process we also call it as. This process is called as cyanide process. Oxidation followed by reduction. Remember, very, very important step. Hydrometallurgy also we call it as. Reaction, what will happen? Here, remember, this oxygen gas is the oxidizing agent. Zinc is the reducing agent. If they ask, remember. So, silver react with NaCN solution in presence of oxygen to form the complex on which zinc replacing silver. So, double decomposition reaction also we will call it as. So, silver is replaced by zinc to form pure silver. This is pure one. This is impure one. Remember that. So this is about extraction of silver or gold. Very important. You remember this terminology, cyanide process. So this is about extraction. So extraction, after that extraction, remember, last step is purification. Purification. So purification, remember, purification, first step, distillation. What is distillation? Distillation in which, remember, low boiling point metals are used. Distillation in which low boiling point metal. Remember that principle and example. Zinc, cadmium and mercury. All are, remember, D block element. Remember it like this. D block element. So zinc, cadmium and mercury. Then liquation. Liquation is a process where low melting point metal is purified. Low melting point metal is purified. So remember, tin, lead, bismuth, mercury. All these are P block element. Only mercury is belongs to both. So D block only, but belongs to both. Distillation also and liquation also. Mercury, tin, bismuth, lead and mercury. Because these are all having low melting point. Remember that. So after this, remember, the second one electrolytic refining method. In case of the electrolytic refining method, very important, copper and zinc is purified in this method. Remember, anode made up of impure metal, cathode made up of pure metal, very important. Now impurity from anode will comes to the solution, and the from solution it will goes to the cathode. And here, which is the electrolyte, so remember, electrolyte used is a sulfate of the same metal, solution you can consider. That is, for example, Cu, if it is CuSO4, Zn, ZnSO4, like that. So cathode anode, then anode mud, mainly in case of the copper extraction, if they ask, silver or gold present as a anode mud. Very important, anode made up of impure metal, cathode made up of pure metal, electrolyte is the same metal salt solution, that is sulfate is very best metal sulfate solution, then the anode mud is silver or gold. This is about third one, electrolytic refining method. And the fourth one, remember, zone refining method. So what is zone refining? Zone refining is a method where it can be used only when impurities are more soluble in the molten metal than solid metal. Remember, very important, molten metal than the solid metal. So ultra pure metal is obtained from this. Ultra pure metal and semiconducting materials like germanium, silicon, indium, you can purify in this particular case. So silicon, germanium, gallium, such type of semiconducting materials can be purified. Very important, zone refining. Remember these terminologies to solve the question. Then it comes vapor phase refining method. Remember, in case of the vapor phase refining method, I'll take it like this. So first condition you have to remember. Condition is what? Condition is impure metal should form volatile complex first. So impure metal should have form volatile complex, then volatile compound should undergo decomposition easily. So two example. One is Mohn's process, another one is Van Arkel method. Remember quickly, Mohn's process is used for nickel, Van Arkel method is used for titanium or zirconium. So nickel react with carbon monoxide to form nickel carbonyl, on heating give rise to pure nickel. Similarly, iodine is the reagent used here. Very important, once it was asked in CET, what all the impurities present in titanium or zirconium? That is oxygen and nitrogen gas impurity. Van Arkel method used for titanium or zirconium, oxygen and nitrogen is present as impurity. Remember that, very important point. So this completes quick synopsis part in this case. Now we'll move to the previous year questions. So first one. So if you read the synopsis, then these questions are very simple. In 10 minutes, we'll finish 5 years question paper. So electrolytic refining is used to purify which of the following metal? Very important, asked in 2018, right? So electrolytic refining, I told, copper and zinc, right? So very important. This is used in which case? So zone refining method. This is used in which case? Van Arkel method. Just now I have discussed. That is the advantage of synopsis. Remember, once you read the synopsis or listen the synopsis, you can solve the question very easily. Zinc and mercury is used in distillation. Remember, distillation method. So this is answer for this particular question is A. Common impurity present in bauxite. Remember, important 2018 asked question. Common impurity, generally we will not select Fe2O3 because Fe2O3 will feel that hematite ore. But remember, in bauxite, Fe2O3 is the impurity. So to confuse the students, they have set this particular question. Very important, remember, other than this there was SiO2, and other than this there was TiO2. They could have given TiO2 or SiO2, but to check your knowledge, remember, they have set the question Fe2O3 is present as impurity in the bauxite ore. Very important, remember that. Third question. In case of the third question, remember, the metal extracted by leaching with cyanide. Very important, I told, leaching with cyanide, 2017 asked question. Yaudu, faster helpeku. Silver, very good. Silver is the answer. Then, extraction of chlorine. Remember, extraction of chlorine from Rhine solution is based on, I told this, extraction of chlorine. Remember, NaCl is electrolyzed in ACl solution. So Cl2 gas is liberated. Very easy. Cl minus is the anion, right? Anion always move towards which electrode? Anode. Anode, which reaction take place? Oxidation. Anode oxidation, cathode reduction. Hence, remember, the answer for this particular question is oxidation. So oxidation is the answer, that is A. Then fifth one, I told this also. Van Arkel method of refining of zirconium involves, 2016 asked question it is. Van Arkel method of zirconium involves, remember, removing all oxygen or nitrogen as impurity. Synopsis should be very clear. Synopsis in adru nivu odididre, this answer will feel that it is very easy. So removing all oxygen and nitrogen as impurity. These are the options which are wrong. Then sixth question, composition of copper mat. Very, very important question which was asked in JEE NEET also, remember. Copper mat. Copper mat is Cu2S and FeS. In synopsis, I forgot to tell about this. Very, very important. Remember, Cu2S and FeS is known as copper mat. Copper mat here, Cu2S and FeS. Then, question number 7. So, question number 7. In 2016 asked question, remember, 2016 asked, complex formed when bauxite undergo leaching by the reaction with concentrated NaOH. So which is the complex? Yes, very, very good, very good. You have selected the answer A, NaAlOH 4 times. So question number 8, cryolite is, 2015 asked question, it should be very clear. Cryolite formula is, if you don't remember, also remember, so they have only given this formula, Na3AlF6, they only gave, no problem at all. But you have to know the use of cryolite. Why it is used? I told, cryolite is used to increase the conductivity and decrease the melting point. Increase the conductivity, decrease the melting point. Hence, remember, electrons of alumina for decreasing electric conductivity, not only decreasing, hence it is wrong. Is used in electrolysis of alumina for lowering the melting point, not only lowering, answer is wrong. Electrolysis of alumina for increasing electric conductivity and lowering the melting point of alumina, very, very good. This answer is the correct one. So this is, and this is not the answer. So 2015 asked a question, remember that. 10th question that is asked in 2014, the statement that is not correct is, so furnace lined with hematite is used for conversion of cast iron to wrought iron. Collectors enhance the wettability of mineral particle. Vapor phase refining metal shield from volatile complex. Copper from low grade ores extracted by hydrometallurgy. Very important point. Remember, sometime if you don't know all the four statements also, if you know one at least, see, I told collectors are used for to increase non-wettability. They have given wettability. Hence, definitely the answer for this particular question is B. Then the 11th, process of zone refining is used for the purification of, remember, zone refining means which one? So germanium, semiconducting material, remember that. The last question, 2013 asked question, when limestone is heated, CO2 is given off, metallurgical operation is, limestone is, remember, CaCO3, CaCO3 on heating give rise to CaO plus CO2. CaCO3 give rise to CaO plus CO2. What is the process called? So process is calcination. Remember, the process is calcination. Very, very important. 12th question answer is calcination. 2013 up to 2013 I have solved. So if you have understood the synopsis and the question, please like the video, share the video and subscribe to my channel if you are not subscribed. Thank you. Have a nice day.